Kind of today's been one of these days where you sort of struggle to go wrong to a certain extent, but it's trying to find things that are really interesting versus things that are just okay. I'm not sure how good a job I'm doing. The mist is still coming and going, we've still got a lot of cloud, but it's quite bright because the sun's over that way now. So I'm going to stick some filters on. And with a wider lens, you can see the river down below, so that's like a graduated filter on to, you know, pull back the sky so that I can bring out a bit more detail down below. Colourful as well, with the different mosses and lichens that are around, but it means it's really spongy, so it's pretty easy to wobble the tripod. Doesn't seem to be affecting it too much anymore, but yeah, I've got a few shots in here. We'll see what they're like and we shall move on. I'm just going to go back down the path to, there's a set of water or rapids over there, so I'm going to set up there. It's a place that I've found the last couple of times I've been here, but I just haven't felt like the right colours, so give that a try. And I think once we've left there, I think that will be us for the day. So one more place.
Falls. Still the wrong time of year, I think.
is it, maybe. And we didn't have the light. We don't have much light today either, but what I do have is cloud down over the hills. So I've got the river, the waterfall, and a whole load of colour in the trees. I think you probably saw that when I walked up here, the last sort of shots you took. I set up here mainly because I get to have some heather in the foreground with the rocks leading down the water, and then the water curves round with the falls, and then the trees and the colours in behind it. I don't think I really need anything particularly fancy. I've got it level using the bubble level here. Shoot manual F16. Got about an 80 per second, so I'll stick an ND filter on just to smooth out the water, and I'm going to stick a grad on. Although there's no direct light, the sky is still quite bright with keeping the clouds down, so I kind of want to balance that so I'm not losing too much detail here and then having to go too much out of the shadows. I've got the filters, I might as well use them. Filter holder already has the 0.6 soft edge, so I'll probably use that in conjunction with a 3-stop or a 6-stop ND. One thing I have noticed today, due to the level of moisture that's in the atmosphere, everything, and I mean everything, is ending up in thin layers of condensation. No matter how often you try and clean it, you still end up with condensation. It's not great, it's a bit of a battle, but getting there. This is probably going to be the last location, so I'll get a few shots taken here, and I think we'll probably call it a day after that. Right, I'm going to 3-stop ND, and I put my polarizer on as well because there's just too much glare in the water. So I'll show you what it looks like with the polarizer and the not polarized.
So this is it, non-polarised, quite bright on the water, and that's the polarising coming in. As you can see, it darkens the rocks and takes the glare off the water surface.
So that's me back at the car,
and about head home. So it's been a great morning. Hopefully got something out of it. So as you say, thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye bye for now.